Scientists are working to bring back the extinct woolly mammoths. They claim they can achieve this goal within 4 years. The company named Colossal, established to accomplish this aim by 2027, recently announced it received a $150 million investment. This company plans to reintroduce these enormous animals to the Siberian plains thousands of years after their extinction. Not just mammoths, they also assert that many other extinct species, like the Tasmanian tiger and the dodo, could be revived if they can bring back so many species. Could they also resurrect dinosaurs? This scenario is reminiscent of the Jurassic Park movie we all remember. After all, let's not create more problems for ourselves, right? 3 years after the Jurassic Park film, Pleistocene Park was established in Yakutia, and experiments began with some animals. But is it really possible to bring back species that have completely vanished? Some animals that were not yet extinct had previously been cloned. Another creature brought back through genetic engineering from a recently extinct species survived for only 7 minutes. Now, scientists claim they are ready for much larger, more permanent experiments. However, some experts vehemently oppose this situation. What benefit do dead mammoths bring? Can reviving them solve our climate problems? How ethical is it to manipulate the genes of creatures we know so little about? In an era where we are witnessing the sixth extinction, does the return of mammoths herald a mass revival? In a moment, we will visit three different islands. So, if you're ready, let's start exploring these islands. In the video shot in 1933, the animal you see is named Benjamin. He was a Tasmanian tiger, and he died 18 months after this footage was taken. He was the last Tasmanian tiger in the world. About 90 years ago, after being seen for the last time on this island, he was added to the list of extinct animals. So, how long is this list? While you watch this video, another species will go extinct. Three species are disappearing every hour. Humans are driving a million species toward extinction. Among all these extinct species, there is one that has become a symbol of extinction itself. No, not mammoths. A bird, the dodo. The dodo was a very mysterious bird. Standing about a meter tall, it wandered around the island of Mauritius. For a long time, humanity thought it was a creature from fairy tales, like dragons or unicorns. However, historical records indicate that in 1598, Dutch sailors landed on this paradise-like island in the Indian Ocean. Having never seen humans before, these beautiful birds, which could neither fly nor run, were easily hunted. The pigs, rats, and goats brought by the sailors also destroyed the dodo's eggs. After being last seen on this island about 350 years ago, the dodo bird became a symbol of extinction caused by human impact. Woolly mammoths and elephants are very close relatives, especially Asian elephants. Their genomes are about 99% identical. So if you have an Asian elephant, you essentially have a 99% mammoth genetically. This is what scientists are trying to do. We know the genetic sequences for both elephants and mammoths. We have two genetic sequences written with the letters A, C, G, and T. If we compare these two sequences, we can find the different segments. Then we can cut the different parts from the elephant's genes and replace them with the mammoth's. In other words, we can insert the information that makes a mammoth, like its woolly coat. Yes, it's basically a copy-paste operation. How do we do this in word processing software like Word? By using a command like find and replace. Now, we have a technological tool that can do this genetically, CRISPR-Cas9. This process has already been attempted with an elephant's DNA. Not completely, but they made changes to three genes. They cut the information related to blood cells in the elephant's genetic code and replaced it with information from the extinct mammoth. By changing just these three segments, they discovered that the elephant's oxygen carrying capacity in cold conditions increased. Following this, a group of researchers at Harvard created a list of all the different genes and managed to design a mammoth cell in the lab by changing 14 of them. All 14 changes were successful. So right now in a lab somewhere in the world, there's a genetically engineered living mammoth cell. The DNA of this cell is partially mammoth. Now they are moving on to the next phase. They will try to bring a mammoth back to life by using an Asian elephant. However, there are some very challenging technical problems to solve regarding the 22-month pregnancy of elephants. This is what the team is working on. And yes, the person on the far right, as you might have noticed, is George Church. Let's think of him as Dr. Allen from Jurassic Park. He's not just the father of genomic science, he's also an entrepreneur. He is one of the co-founders of a company called Colossal, because to undertake these projects, a significant amount of money is needed. But who would benefit from bringing mammoths back to life? I mean, commercially, that doesn't seem profitable. The meat of these animals is tough. You can't just chop it up and eat it. We need a really crazy rich person for this. Just like in Jurassic Park, a wealthy entrepreneur. So far, we have two eager scientists who are experts in their fields. But who will be the real-world counterpart of the mysterious wealthy person in this picture? Let's take a look at the company structure of Colossal, which was founded to make this happen. As you can see, they now have a total of 34 investors, including the latest round of funding on January 31st, 2023. And they've raised nearly $250 million in total so far. This means someone has invested a significant amount of money in a project that is very risky in terms of return on investment. One investor really caught my attention, InQtel, an investment firm from Arlington, Virginia. Let's dive into the details of this. It turns out this is a government institution. Let's check out their website. Look, they've listed the areas they invest in. Isn't that interesting? They're curious about fringe science topics. When we look at the About section of the site, we find out which government agency is backing them, the CIA. Remember, this is what Beth Shapiro said. She also wrote the book on de-extinction. Yes, even if we bring a mammoth back, what we're actually creating is a kind of elephant hybrid, a proxy. In 2016, a report was released discussing the ethics of this work, outlining the pros and cons and addressing the risks involved. In summary, while this technology has tremendous potential, we must act very responsibly, considering its ethical implications. What we learn while trying to bring back mammoths might help prevent the extinction of the dwindling elephant population. We could save species, habitats, and ecosystems during this sixth mass extinction. Understanding extinct and existing species at a genetic level is a good thing. That's settled. We're no longer asking, can we bring back mammoths? Instead, we're discussing, will this happen in 2026 or 2027? How this technology is used and by whom is a topic that deserves careful consideration. Now, we have a more important question on our agenda than, can we do this? Should we do it? If we can, should we? What an ethical conversation, right? This was discussed in 2015, and Beth Shapiro, who conducted it, recently joined Colossal. After mentioning that detail, let's go back to 2015. After asking the question, should we do this, she picks up her book and says, as someone who has written this book, you think I have a clear, direct, and honest answer to this question, right? Yes, I do.